Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, Rosa Irma, good morning. How are you?
I feel
Sleep.
very
Very tired.
Yes.
Ay, no.
Me acosté casi a las 12 por estar haciendo una tarea de la universidad.
Ay, no, sí que bien pesado les toca, ¿verdad?
Sí, es que las maestrías sí son más pesadas que, porque lo llevan a uno así como que
Corriendo.
bien, así.
¿Y de dónde es? ¿De la Nacional o de...?
De la Gavidia.
¿Y este es su primer año?
Sí, ya, de hecho, ya con este examen que presentamos terminamos ya como el primer año.
Y le falta el otro.
Me falta todo este año que finaliza en marzo del otro. Y ahí termina todo ya.
2 años son, ¿verdad?
Sí, 2 años, pero es bien pesado. Porque
Ay.
Cada mes, o sea, una materia por mes, pero así es. No he terminado uno de hacer como los trabajos y ya están alojados los siguientes evaluaciones.
Ay,
O sea,
no.
no hay descanso para nada.
Sí, así le toca a alguien que yo conozco también. Está sacando la carrera, pero very, 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 very hard.
Sí.
Good morning, José.
Good morning.
Morning. Sí, así que bien pesado. Superarse cuesta.
Sí, cuesta. El que no se sacrifica, ese no.
No logra nada nunca.
Sí.
Sí, porque es bien difícil. To be early in the morning. Imagínese usted, se duerme de noche con su maestría. Se levanta temprano con English. It's like.
Sí, pero me gusta.
Bueno, ahí está todo. Si a usted le gusta algo, lo va a disfrutar, si no, no.
Y lo que quisiera es poder hablar inglés bien fluido y todo, pero creo que requiere bastante que uno se ponga a practicar, ¿verdad?
Sí, es que eso es, y ese es el inglés y en cualquier idioma. ¿Sí? Inglés y cualquier idioma, le digo.
¿Y usted sabe otro idioma aparte del inglés?
Fíjese de que empecé a estudiar francés, pero no mucho me agrada.
No, so, oui, oui.
Ajá, I like also, bueno, estudié japonés 3 años.
¿Habla en japonés algo?
Ah, ohayou gozaimasu, watashi wa anarusu desu. Quiero ver el neerlandés, lo entiendo, porque una amiga vive allá en Bélgica, entonces a veces me mandaba las tareas para que le ayudara y como hay cosas que se parecen bastante al inglés, lo entiendo. Si lo leo, lo entiendo, el neerlandés, pero hablarlo es bien difícil.
De ver.
Porque va combinado como con alemán y francés. Ay, no. Tengo facilidad para entender los idiomas. Yo sé si es coreano, si es japonés, si es porque me gusta el coreano también. Pero sí, aprender un idioma no es tan sencillo.
Qué bien.
Sí, pero es bonito.
Sí.
It is nice. Ok, well, everybody, good morning. Ahí veo a José, Pablo. Let me see who else, Sara, Carol, and Ana Patricia, and Andrea. Okay, good morning. I'm gonna call out the list, okay, for the attendance. Pablo Ernesto Campos.
I'm here.
Okay, very good. Hugo, Hugo Ernesto Gil, todavía no ha venido. Juan José González.
Present.
Okay, Sara Jacobo.
Good morning, I'm present.
Good morning, Connie Andres. Todavía no ha venido. Carlos Humberto Lima. He's not present. Luis Fernando no ha venido. Isabel Mejía. Not here. Todavía no. Ok. Ana Patricia Melara.
Good morning.
Good morning. Carol Membreño. Carol.
Good morning.
Hi, Carol. Good morning. Rosa Irma Méndez.
Good morning.
Danilo Morales. Not here. Nelson Quintanilla.
I'm here.
Okay. Erwin Rivera, not here. Cuando miro ese nombre, Erwin Rivera, se me viene a la mente alguien de música banda. Sierra Raquel, not here. Andrea Ticas.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning. En José Roberto Vázquez. José Roberto Vázquez.
Good morning.
Good morning. All right. Hoy los escucho así como que están cansados. ¿Se durmieron noche ayer?
Yes.
Ay, sí.
Acá ando pendientes.
Ay, se oyen un poquito cansados, pero ya solo mañana, ¿ok? Only tomorrow. Only tomorrow. Yo sé que cuesta un poquito. Imagínense, ya llevamos la clase número 11 ahora. Class number 11, so tomorrow is class. Ya casi terminamos el módulo bien rápido. Very, very fast. Okay. Well, we're going to begin today, and I'm going to share my presentation. Can you see? No, give me a second. Can you see my presentation?
Yes.
Okay, very good. So, well, welcome to class number 11, all right? Practically, we are in unit number 3, okay? Communication at the workplace. But tenemos pendiente todavía. We have to continue with some things of the simple past, okay? Tenemos algunas cosas pendientes del pasado todavía. Simple past, okay? So, well, so here we have the word teacher. How many, listen to my question, how many letters the word teacher has? ¿Cuántas letras tiene esa palabra? Teacher, how many letters?
Eight letters.
Eight letters. One, two, three, four, five, six. Eight or seven?
Seven.
Seven. All right, very good. How many vowels? How many vowels do we have? ¿Cuántas vocales? How many vowels?
Two.
Okay, we have three. Two E and one A. Okay, very good. Two E and one A. And how many consonants we have?
Four.
Okay, very good. Now, the activity that we have today is, to begin, is we have the word teacher here. Now, if I take, give me a second, if I take an A, and if I take a T, I form the word
fish,
cat. Okay, very good. Okay, if I get the C, the A, the T, I get the word cat. Okay, so con estas letras nada más, with only these letters, we can form new words. We can form new words. For example, C-A-T, cat. Okay. What about another? ¿Qué otra palabra podríamos sacar solo con esas letras? Only with those letters. Yes, Juan José?
Tía. T.
T. Very good. Okay, another.
Catcher.
Catcher. Yes, very good. Cat.
Each.
Catcher. Sorry?
Each.
Very good. Very good. What else?
It.
Eat, perfect, very good. What else?
Eight.
Ah, sorry, catcher, no, because no tenemos dos C, so catcher, no. Mm-hmm.
Teach, okay. Teach, de enseñar.
Ah, teach, very good. What else? What else?
Eight.
Her.
Eight in simple past. Her. Very good. Yeah. What else?
Here.
Here. Let me see. H-E-A. Yeah, we have here. Okay. Another.
He.
He. Okay. Very good.
At.
Excellent, Sara. At. Very good.
Hat.
Hat. Yes. Very good. What else?
Reach.
Reach. Let me see. Reach. Yes. Reach. Alcanzar. Mm-hmm. Reach. What else? What else, everybody? Very, ooh, we can, I'm gonna tell you something. The record, el record de palabras que hemos obtenido, well, in my case, has been 60. 60. Hate. Sorry?
Hate.
Hate, very good. Excellent, another. Okay, hate. Another.
Here, como de oír. Here.
Here. Here. Yes, very good, Juan Jose. Here. Excellent, excellent. Very good. Yes.
Catch. Catch.
Catch.
Catch.
Catch. C-A-T-C-H-E-R. Catcher. Catcher. No, porque tiene dos C. It has two C, and we have only one. But we can have catch. Catch, yes. Catch is correct. Catch. Ah, no, no, no. Tampoco, porque tiene dos C. It has two C. Y aquí en la palabra solo tenemos una. We have only one. Mm-hmm. Okay, what else?
Ear.
Ear, yeah, ear. Oreja, very good. Ear. Yes. We can have a lot of words. Okay, if we can have here, what is the opposite of here, everybody? What's the opposite of here? Can you tell me? Here. Here is aquí. How do you say allá?
There.
There. Very good. Yes, this is another. There. Okay. Let me see how many we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 16. Okay. We can have more. More. Okay.
Heart.
Heart. Very good. Heart. Excellent. What else? We can have a words with two letters. How do you say in English ella? No, we have he, her. Yeah, we have he, her. At, okay. What else? How do you say we have hate? Yes, we have hate too. Mm-hmm. Gato, we have cat. How do you say, everybody, tierra, planeta tierra?
Earth.
Very good, earth. So earth, yeah, that's another. How do you say, everybody, engañar or copiar. Okay, how do you say copiar? Or engañar. You say cheat.
Cheat.
Cheat, okay? Y la persona que lo hace, the person who does it is a cheater. All right, cheat, cheater. What else?
Art.
Hard. Yeah,
we no, have art.
Ah, art. Art. Yes, yes, very good, Juan Jose. Art, very good. Art. Another one. How do you say lágrima in English?
Tear.
Sorry?
Tear.
Tear. Very good. Tear. Excellent. We say tear. Tears for fears. There is a group that is called like that. What else? ¿Qué otra podemos formar? What other words can we have? Or only that, everybody. No more. Let me see. We have at.
Rate.
Sorry.
Rate. R-A-T-E.
Exactly. R-A-T-E. Rate. Very good. Yes. Excellent. Okay. Another.
Race.
Yes, very good. Race. Very good. Competencia. Race. Okay. Very good.
Rat.
Sorry? Rat.
Rat.
Yes. Rat. Excellent. Very good. What else? We have 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. We have 24 in this moment. Hagamos las 30. Tenemos 25. We have 25. Let's make 30. Hagamos la mitad de esas 60. Porque salen 60. 60 words. But I would like you to tell me 5 more so we can have 30.
Racer.
Racer. Let me see. Let me see. R-A-C-E. No, because we only have one R.
Oh, okay.
Yes, we only have one R. Yeah, but if how do you say everybody tres?
Three.
All right, very good. That is one. That is one. Another that we can have?
Three.
Very good. Yes. Okay. Nice. Three more words.
Act.
Sorry?
Act.
Act. Uh-huh. Let me see. Act. We don't act. No, we don't have it. Act. Very good. Act. Nice.
Great.
Oh, sorry?
Ya está.
Yeah. Great. We got it. Great.
Catch.
Catch.
It's double T. No.
A double C? Uh-huh. We can't because a catch is double C. And we have only one. Okay, everybody, what's the abbreviation of technology? What's the abbreviation of technology?
Tech.
Tech, very good, Sara. T-E-C-H, tech. Okay, one more, and we have the 30. Una más y tenemos las 30. Go ahead, one more and we have the 30.
There,
let me see. We got it. We got it. Mm-hmm. Ya la tenemos. We got it. There. Okay. How do you say everybody? En la baraja están varias cartas, right? El rey, la jota. How do you say el as, la? How do you say that in English? Where you can make poker. Okay, you call it ace.
Ace.
No, sorry.
No tenemos aún.
El de verbo to be, right?
Sí.
Yeah, we are. Very good. Yes, we don't have it. Are. Okay. Chair. Sorry?
Create.
Chair.
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 Chair. Chair the singer or this chair. Like this?
E-R.
Oh, cheer. Ah, yes, that's good. Cheer. Ese es como animar. Wow. Cheer. Excellent. Very good. Nice. Cheer. C-H-E-E-R. Okay. Okay, let's see how many we have. We have 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 30, 31, 32. Okay. We have in total, right, as a group, 33. Excellent. Very good. ¿Quién se imagina que de esa palabra salen ese montón? All right. Very good. Okay. Nice. ¿Alguna palabra que usted no conozca, que sea nueva? Can you tell me? A word that is new for you. A word that is new for you. For example, do you know the meaning of each? Each. Do you know the meaning of each?
Cada.
Cada. Very good. All right. What about the meaning of rich? Do you know the meaning of rich? Yes or no? No? Alcanzar. All right. The meaning of this is alcanzar. Por ejemplo, usted quiere decir, yo quiero alcanzar mi meta. I want to reach my goal, all right, my objective. Okay, let's see, here, do you know the meaning of here? This is like oír, right, here, because escuchar is listen, all right, oír, hear, escuchar, listen. Now, do you know the meaning of cheat? Cheat is engañar. Yes, very good. Engañar. And cheater es la persona que engaña, right? Cheater. What about tear? Do you know the meaning of tear?
Lágrima.
Lágrima, very good. Lágrima, or it can be romper. Como rasgar, hacer esto, this, ok, that is tear. Y también, por ejemplo, si a usted se le rompe el pantalón, así se dice también, oh my God, my pants, the simple past of tear is tore, ok, very good, tear, tore, tore, mm-hmm. Tear, tore, all right, very good, tear, tore. Okay, let's see, rate. What's the meaning of rate? What do you think the meaning of rate is? No idea, es como poner en un ranking, all right? For example, cuando clasifican las películas, right? Movies are rated. For example, this one in English, when you have a movie with this symbol, that means that it's restricted. Okay, this one is a PG-13, for example. This is parental guide. Puede entrar un niño de 13 años, pero con parental guide. And then we have a restricted is R. And then we have, I don't remember, triple X. No, I don't remember. Okay, let's see. What's the meaning of race?
Carrera.
Carrera, very good. And what's the meaning of, I told you, the meaning of ace? Let's see if you remember.
El
as de la baraja, right? Very good, ace. And what about cheer?
Salud.
Okay, that is cheers. Cheers. Ese es el cheers, pero con ese. Right? Cheers.
Alegría.
Ajá, como animar a alguien. Por ejemplo, Pablo, cheers. José Roberto is your name, right? José Roberto.
Yes.
Pablo, cheers, José Roberto, every day. Like, hey, yes, come on, you can do it. Yes or no?
Yes.
All days. Yeah, you are co-workers, right? And friends, I imagine.
Yes.
Okay, very good. So you cheer. Ustedes se animan el uno al otro. You cheer each other. Ay, sí, hay que animarnos porque miren que la vida solo es working, working and working. Así que cuando se puede escapar a la playa, vaya. Okay, very good. Yes, because life is only working, 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 working. All right. So you have to cheer each other. Cheer each other. All right, very good. Okay, well, we're gonna finish here. I'm gonna erase this. All right, very good. Excellent. Okay, and we will move to the next activity. Okay, the next activity is, vamos a repasar un poquito, affirmative and negative sentences, all right, with a verb to be. Affirmative and negative, but give me a second because this is not here. No me abrió la pestañita, quiero ver. Okay. No, it's not this one. Give me a second, everybody, because I don't know. I don't know what happens here. Okay, give me a second. I have the it's not this, is this one. Okay, very good. Okay, we're gonna practice a little bit of affirmative and negative sentences. Hoy tenemos un pequeño examencito, right? De verbos o verbs. But it's gonna be very, very easy. I mean, hay algunos verbos que los podemos relacionar por lógica. Okay, but here we have this worksheet that we are gonna work. All right, very good, that we're gonna work. We're gonna work a little bit of affirmative sentences, and we are going to practice a little bit of negative sentences. Okay, very good, negative sentences. Now, here, in the first one, we have to fill in the blanks with some verbs. Si quieren, le vamos a tomar foto a esto. We're gonna take a little picture. Please take a little picture. And we are gonna go to complete this. Vamos a ir a completarlo. Okay. You take a little picture. Do you have the picture?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, very good, very good. Okay, vale, lo vamos a ir a trabajar. We're gonna work like with another person, okay? And after that, después lo vamos a completar. We're gonna complete it. Okay, give me a second. Okay, we're gonna work like this. Algunos vamos a trabajar in pairs. Okay, so let's see, we're gonna work por unos minutitos porque no está muy difícil, all right, very good. Okay, okay. All right, very good. Let's go.
Spend. Spended.
Spended.
Spended. Spended. El de go is went.
Play it.
El play, play it.
Play it, correcto.
Okay, very good, everybody. Was it easy or difficult? What do you think?
Kind of.
So, all right. Tenemos que aprendernos mejor los verbos, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. Now, we're going to complete this. Juan José, can you help me with the first one, please? Read the sentence and tell me the verbs, and I'm going to type. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, when I was.
Excellent. Yes.
When I was in Japan, I found everything very different.
Okay, very good. Found. Okay.
Found. Okay.
Found. All right, very good. Very good. Excellent. Yo no sé si ustedes tienen ahorita cuaderno a la mano. No sé. I don't know. Pero lo que pueden hacer es esto. Okay, ponen acá. Be. Was. Find. Found. All right, very good. Find, found. Be, was. Find, found. Okay, very good. Yo les voy a mandar una listita de verbos después. No les he querido mandar una porque a veces son listas, tamañas listotas, right? Y uno se va como que, ay, no, y todo esto me tengo que aprender. Por eso es que prefiero mejor que salgan los verbos de la práctica. All right, practice. Okay, let's see. 2 years ago, el examencito de ahora va a ser como diagnóstico, right? Okay, it's going to be the same. It's going to be a little bit of diagnosis. So, si depende cómo me salgan, lo puedo volver a repetir el día de mañana el mismo para que se aprendan los verbos, all right? So, 2 years ago, sorry. Thank you, Juan José. José Roberto, help me with the next one, please.
Okay, 2 years ago. My parents bought a new car.
Excellent. And how do you spell bought, José Roberto?
Why? Perdón?
How do you spell bought?
How do you spell? What's the meaning?
B.
Ah, perdón. B. O. U. G. H. T.
Excellent. Very good. Nice. Es porque mucha gente dice TH, and it is not both, it is both. Okay, very good. Thank you. Sara, can you help me with the next one, please?
Last summer, Peter spent his holiday in a summer camp with his friend. They went swim, they played football and golf, and they visited many interesting places.
Very good. Visited. Excellent. So 2 years ago, my parents, okay, the verbs, by, okay, we're gonna continue with this. By boat, all right, very good. By boat, then we have go, went. Go, went. Play, played. Visit, visited. All right, very good. Okay, nice. Thank you, Sara. Rosa Irma, help me with the next one, please.
My sister got a good job in a bank.
Excellent, very good. So we say get, and the simple past is got. All right, very good. So we're gonna write here got. Okay, very good. What about the next one? The next one is gonna be for maybe Nelson. Can you help me?
Okay. Susan here causing came to Portugal 10 years ago.
Very good. Came. Excellent. Very good. So we say come. Come is the verb, and the simple past is came. Very good. Come, came. Very good. Excellent. Okay. Well, this is the first part. The first part of the exercise. Now, we're gonna make a little. Vamos a hacer un pequeño repaso, a little review for the negative sentences. For example. If I have, si yo tengo esta oración, Irma ate pizza last night, okay? What is the negative form, everybody? What's the negative form?
Irma didn't.
Ajá, Irma didn't. In the end, the verb, in present or in past?
It.
Present.
Present. Very good, very good. So Irma didn't eat pizza last night. Okay, very good. Irma didn't eat pizza last night. Okay, what about if I have, for example, we played soccer last weekend. What's the negative sentence? What's the negative
one? We didn't play.
We
soccer
didn't play
last week.
Soccer last weekend. Excellent. Very good. We didn't play soccer last weekend. Excellent. Very good. We didn't play soccer last weekend. If we have this one, I worked hard yesterday, what's the negative form?
I didn't work.
Very good. I didn't work
hard.
Yes.
Yes. Very good. I didn't work hard yesterday. Very good. So no problems with the negative sentences. No problem?
No.
No, okay, bye. Ya me di cuenta. Está bien, muy bien. Le sirvió bastante la tarea. Very good. I'm very happy for that. Okay, very good. Now, una que nos faltaba ya para formar las estructuras y poder pasar así a explicarles la pronunciación. Are the yes, no questions. Okay, very good. Las preguntas yes or no. Estas son bien fáciles, ok. We're gonna use, vamos a usar, we're gonna use first the auxiliary. The auxiliary has to be in present or in past, everybody.
Past.
Ok, very good, excellent. In past, aquí tenemos la estructura. Aquí está la estructura, por si nos cuesta. After the auxiliary, ¿qué necesitamos? After the auxiliary, what do we need?
The subject.
The subject, very good. So the auxiliary, after the auxiliary, the subject. And after the subject, what do we have?
Verb.
And the verb is in present or in past?
Present.
Present.
Entonces, solo en qué oraciones vamos a poner el verbo en pasado?
Affirmative.
Affirmative, very good. Affirmative. In negative, in questions, no. Porque aquí tenemos el did representando el pasado, right? And in the negative form, we have didn't representing the past. Now, did you sleep well? Yo le voy a hacer esta pregunta. Did you sleep well yesterday? ¿Durmieron bien ayer? Did you sleep well yesterday?
No, I didn't.
Ay, Rosa Irma, sorry. You can say, yes, I did, or no, I didn't. In my case, kind of. Kind of. Nelson, did you sleep well yesterday?
Did you?
Did you sleep well yesterday?
Yes.
You can say, yes, I did, or no, I didn't, right? ¿Durmió bien ayer? Did you sleep well yesterday?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, very good. Okay, thank you. Danilo, did you sleep well yesterday?
Yes, I did.
Excellent, very good. Andrea, did you sleep well yesterday?
Yes, I didn't.
Repeat, please.
Yes, I did.
Excellent.
Sorry.
I was like, okay, don't worry, don't worry. Okay. Luis, did you sleep well yesterday?
Yes, I did.
Excellent, very good. Aquí a estas preguntas les falta algo bien importante, que son las time expressions, las que estábamos viendo ayer. Ok, for example, did you sleep well last night? Aquí les podemos poner al final esto. Es mejor. Ok, la pregunta es más específica. Did you sleep well last night? Did she go to the doctor yesterday morning? Pues mira, ella fue al doctor ayer en la mañana. Did she go to the doctor yesterday morning? All right, very good. You can say, did she... O le podemos cambiar el nombre. Did María, did Rosa, did tu mamá, your mother, did your, tu hermana, did your sister. Ok, very good. So, when we have a question, cuando tenemos una pregunta con she, ¿cómo podemos contestar?
Yes, she.
Ajá, yes, we can answer, yes, she did, or?
No, she didn't.
No, she didn't. For example, let me see. Juan José, did your mother cook for you yesterday?
Yes, yes, she did.
Excellent, very good, excellent. Let's see. Carol. Did your mother call you yesterday?
No, she didn't.
Okay, very good. Okay, excellent. Now, the next one, oh, we podemos cambiar aquí por he también, all right? Did he, pero la respuesta no va a ser yes, she did, or is yes, he did. The next one, did they watch the movie? They. Cuando tenemos they, the answer is?
Yes, they did.
Yeah, yes, they did, or no, they didn't. Ok, very good. Yes, they did. Pero esto de yes, they did, no, they didn't, all right. Eso es la formalidad del lenguaje. Ok, nosotros solo podemos decir yes or no. No problem. Okay, yes, no, a little, a lot, kind of course, no way. All right, very good. ¿Sabe qué significa no way? Ya creo que le dije, ¿verdad? No way. ¿O no? No way. Eso significa de ninguna manera. No way. For example, I say, teacher, did you call your, how can I tell you? Did you drink beer yesterday, teacher? No way. Not yesterday. Maybe tomorrow. No, come on. Okay, very good. So you say no way. Is it clear?
Yeah. Yes.
Very, very good. Mm-hmm. And the last one is he, right? Did he clean his room? Yes, he did. No, he didn't. Okay, very good. Well, si usted quiere, le toma una foto y lo comparto, right? You take a picture and you share. Porque vamos a trabajar la segunda parte del ejercicio. Okay. All right. So we're going to go back to the exercise. And now, esta es la segunda parte, second part. It's kind of, okay. Si quiere, tomemos foto a este primero. Take a picture here. All right. You got it?
Yes.
Okay, very good. This is the first part of the picture. And this is the second part. Aquí. Y la última la trabajamos juntos. All right. We're going to work together. Take a picture to this one.
Yes.
Okay, very good. Now, le voy a dar unos ejemplos. I'm going to give you some examples. For example, aquí ya tenemos las tres cosas mezcladas. Affirmative, negative, and question. ¿Y cómo voy a saber? Okay. Sorry.
Perdón, no le tomé a la segunda. Perdón.
Ah, vaya, ahorita, José Roberto. Give me a second. Vaya. There.
Gracias.
Okay, all right, no problem. Okay. Now here we have, for example, my sister and husband. Esta es una oración afirmativa. ¿Cómo va a ir ese verbo? My sister and husband, and her husband.
Came.
Very good. Came from Greece. Very good. From Grecia. Now, cuando usted mire una oración que diga not like, here is going to be negative form, okay? Negative form. Y cuando mire acá un signo de interrogación, va a ser una pregunta. Por ejemplo, ¿cómo sería la pregunta aquí? The country last Saturday. ¿Qué ponemos primero para hacer una pregunta, everybody?
Did,
okay. So we say, did. After did, ¿qué iba después del did?
They live.
El subject, right? Very good. Subject. Después va el sujeto. So we say, did they? And after the subject?
Like.
El verbo en presente, right? Did they live?
Did they live?
Okay, very good. Did they live? Very good. Did they live? The country last Saturday, y ellos dejaron el país last Saturday, all right? Did they leave? Okay. So right now, para mejor trabajar esto, right, y entenderlo mucho mejor, siempre en el grupo, right? Always in the same group. Okay. Do you have a question, everybody? No?
La verdad, a mí no me quedó muy claro.
¿El qué, José?
Lo que vamos a completar, en fin.
Ah, ok. Vaya, vamos a completar estas oraciones que están aquí, all right. Y usted tiene que ir poniendo atención si son affirmative, si son negative, o si son preguntas, questions.
Ok.
Cuando miremos, por ejemplo, entre paréntesis, not like, esta oración es negative. Cuando veamos solo el verbo encerrado acá, ah, it's affirmative. Y si vemos al final un question mark, it's gonna be a question, okay?
Okay.
Okay, thank you, Jose, for asking. Thank you for asking, okay? Very good. Okay, well, vamos a ir a completar eso, all right? En grupo, in group. Imagínense que este, imagínense que ese fue, hubiera sido el examen. Okay, very good. So, I'm gonna send you right now. Okay, give me a second. No sé por qué me, se mira así en la mañana esta computadora. Maybe for the darkness. Okay, very good. I'm gonna give you some time so you can complete this. Cuando usted entre al, al room, de una vez comparta la imagen para que no le cueste. All right. So, let's go right now. I'm gonna give you... Okay.
El pasado de stay.
Stay, ahí estamos. Vámonos.
Sorry, sorry. It is regular, Juan José. Pablo. It is regular. So, if it is regular, what do you need to add?
Es regular.
It is regular.
ED.
ED. Very good. Yeah. Stayed. Excellent.
Excellent. Home. She.
Les vamos a ver cuánto llevan ahorita. One, two.
Cool.
Todas están perfectas. All of them are nice. Excellent. Solo donde dice did you like the film? Capital letter. Mayúscula, la D primera.
Ah.
Yes. Okay. Did you like? Excellent.
Ay, antes era más fácil usar Paint y ahora ni en el borrador encuentro.
Sí, es cierto. It's true. Ya me ha pasado. Very difficult. Pero,
¿es en serio? ¿No encuentro el borrador?
No, sí. Ah, de veras. Yo no lo veo tampoco ahí.
No.
Ah. Ya, no. Ah, sí, déjelo. Don't worry. Continue. Continue, I'll leave it like that. No problem. Okay. Yeah.
Good.
Hello.
Hello.
Did you finish? No.
Yes.
Yes.
You terminaron las dos capturas. I mean, todos los ejercicios. Yes.
No, only one.
Ajá, yeah. So you finished two or only one?
Only one.
One.
Ah, okay, porque faltaba la otra captura de allá abajo. No, you didn't finish.
No.
Okay, very good. Vaya, le voy a dar unos minutitos más. Lo están haciendo muy bien. Ahorita los que he ido a supervisar así ni se han dado cuenta, right? Okay, I'm gonna give you more minutes. You are doing a very good job. You're doing a very.
¿Cuál es la otra? ¿Cuál es la otra parte?
La que me dijo Roberto que no le había tomado foto. Vaya, esta es una, right?
Sí.
Y aquí siguen, hasta aquí terminan.
Ok, voy a tomar una captura de eso, permítame, por favor.
Ok, terminan acá. They finish here. Yes, they finish here. And this part, esa la vamos a hacer juntos, right? The next part, this one. Okay, that is for all of us together. So, did you take the picture? Yes.
No.
Espérame, ahorita se lo pongo mejor, pero, ok, ahí. There.
Pero la parte esa que dice show is the best. No.
That one is for you and me together.
Okay. Okay.
Very good. You got it?
Yes.
Got it.
All right. Very good. Okay. So we're going to stop the share and I'm going to give you more minutes. Por ahí se unió alguien más. ¿Quién era? Vamos a Raquel. Good morning, Raquel.
Good morning.
Morning. All right. So we're gonna continue, okay, with the second part. I'm gonna send Raquel with Juan Jose and Pablo. Hello, Isabel. Now she's connecting. Hello, Isabel.
Hello, sorry, I'm late.
Don't worry, don't worry. I'm gonna send you to one group because right now we are working, filling some sentences, okay?
Okay.
Now let me see, I'm gonna send you with Jose Roberto and Luis. All right, no.
Okay. Thank you.
Very good. Okay, thank you very much. All right, we're gonna continue completing this. Let's see. Okay, I need a volunteer for number two. A volunteer?
Hi.
Okay, Roberto, tell me.
I didn't like the YouTube concert.
Like this?
Yes.
El verbo en pasado present. O en presente? The verb present. In present.
Present. Past. Present. Okay, I didn't like
very good. We need,
the YouTube concert.
Excellent, very good. All right. Rosa Irma, help me with the next one, please. My cousin.
My cousin. I don't remember the verb past form.
Ah, this is a regular.
My cousin from France yesterday evening.
Okay, very good. Yes. Yeah, it is a regular verb. It is a regular verb. What about the next one? Pablo, help me with the next one, please.
Okay. One Monday, Johan. Get to school foot.
Yeah, okay. Get or went.
Went.
Okay, very good. Went. Thank you very much. Thank you. The next one, Juan Jose, help me with the question, please.
Sería, did you like?
Excellent, very good. Did you like the film? Excellent. Excellent, very good. The next one is for Sarah. Help me, Sarah, please.
They didn't.
Yeah.
Finish the homework yesterday.
Excellent, 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 excellent. Very good. They didn't finish the homework yesterday. Andrea, help me with the next one, please. The question.
Did she go to the cinema with her parents last night?
Excellent, very good. Did she go to the cinema with her parents last night? Luis Fernando, help me with the next one. No, she didn't. She.
Okay, she stayed at home.
Okay.
She got a cold.
Very good. She got a cold. Excellent. Very good. Okay, the next one. The next one is gonna be for Nelson. Help me, Nelson.
We came to Spain by car.
Ah, okay, okay. But the verb in parentheses is go. What is the simple past for the verb go?
Went.
All right, very good. Went. Uh-huh. Excellent. We went to Spain by car. Okay, very good. Thank you. Let's see. Carol, help me with the next one, please.
I had a wonderful holiday with my family that last July.
Very good. Nice. Thank you, Carol. Thank you. Okay. The next one is for Nazareth. Help me with the next one, please.
You travel to Madrid by car or
he played.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah, by car or by plane. Okay. Si, mm-hmm. si se fue en carro o en avión. Okay? Okay. Excellent. Very good. Did you travel to Madrid by car or by plane? Okay. Rosa Irma, help me with the next one, please. Many years ago,
it was very difficult to live without your electronic.
Ah, okay, okay. Without electricity.
Electricity.
Excellent. Very good. Nice. Excellent. Okay. Maybe Maria Isabel can help me with the next one. Please. Last year. Isabel?
Sorry.
No problem. No problem.
Last year they bought a house at the seaside.
Bought. Very good. They bought. Excellent. Danilo, help me with the next one, please.
I met him the day before yesterday.
Okay, how do you spell, ¿cómo se deletrea? How do you spell the met?
M-E-T.
Excellent, very good, nice. Met, that is the pronunciation, right? Met. Yeah, in present, you say meet, and in past, you say met. Okay, met. Very good. Okay. Meet, met. Excellent. Perfect. Okay. Now, here, aquí solo es de escoger la opción. All right. So, what option do we have for the first one? Mrs. Harris took, take, or did take? Which is the option? A, B, or C?
B.
B.
B. B. Yes, it's letter B. Took. Mrs. Harris took the last train. What about the next one? There was or there were? Okay, le voy a ayudar. Le voy a ayudar. Bueno, yes. The B is where. Okay, there were, habían muchas personas, okay? Ese there was, there were, ustedes no sé si alguna vez han estudiado, there is y there are. ¿Ya lo han estudiado? ¿No?
No
recuerdo.
Yes. Ah, you don't remember. Vaya, there is, there are. Estos dos los ocupamos cuando queremos decir, por ejemplo, en mi casa hay una piscina, hay una cancha de tenis, por ejemplo, hay dos televisores, hay... Cuando hablamos de eso, decimos there is y there are. Por ejemplo, in my house there is a swimming pool, there is a bed, there are two televisions. Cuando hablamos de eso, vaya, pero en pasado, si queremos decir había, singular, there was. Habían, there were. ¿Ok? Entonces en la número dos dice, habían muchas personas aquí anoche. There were many people here last night. ¿Ok? All right, what about the next one? Which is the option? A, B, or C?
Was.
Yeah, letter B. Él estaba. He was at home with me yesterday. What about the next one?
She went.
Yes, is letter?
C.
C, went. Very good. She went. On holidays. Very good. What about the next one? He
bought.
Excellent. So, letter A or B?
B.
¿Con la R o sin la R?
B.
Very good. Yes. Porque ese que tiene R, ya le voy a enseñar el pasado de este verbo. Traer in English is bring. And the past is brought. Okay. Bring, brought. Bring, brought. Okay, very good. What about the next one? A, B, or C? They.
They. A.
Live.
Live. Okay, this is the present.
Left.
Very good. So this is the present and this is the past. O sea, el pasado de este verbo es este. So it's letter C. ¿Ok? No podemos decir live porque la oración está en pasado. Tenemos que poner el verbo en pasado. Ok. What about the next one? She. Take. Taken or took.
Took.
Took. Very good. So the simple past. El pasado de take, yes?
Took, teacher. One question.
Yes,
but left. Sorry. El significado left es izquierda también.
También. Yes, vaya, algo importante que usted me acaba de preguntar. En inglés dividimos las palabras así, mire, el vocabulario se divide así. Todas las oraciones en todo lenguaje tienen sujeto, verbo, complemento. En cualquier lenguaje, en chino, en cualquiera. Subject, verb, and complement. ¿Ok? Now, para poder hablar un idioma, otro que no sea el de nosotros, tenemos que aprender como el vocabulario alrededor de ese subject, verb, and complement. Tenemos que aprender nouns, sustantivos, adjectives, verbs, adverbs, prepositions. Okay, we have the adverbs, prepositions, interjections, conjunctions. Todo esto tenemos que aprender para aprender un idioma nuevo. Nosotros ahorita estamos aprendiendo, we are learning verbs in past. Ya vimos un poco de adjectives. Y los nouns son todas aquellas palabras que le dan nombre a las cosas. For example, what's this?
It's a pencil.
Pencil, very good. All right. Esa palabra, pencil, es un sustantivo. It is a noun. Ya va a ver por qué le estoy explicando esto. What's the name of this? What's the name of this, everybody? Vamos a ver si se puede en el nombre de esto. What's the name of this? What's this? No idea.
No idea.
No.
Okay, this is a stapler. Stapler. Okay, very good. Se escribe así, ya les digo, stapler. Okay, stapler. Very good. How do you say in English, everybody, agua?
Water.
¿Y cómo se dice regar in English? Regar las plantas. Se dice igual, water, ok, water. So, water puede ser un noun o puede ser un verb, ok. Entonces, ¿quién me hizo esa pregunta? Nazaret.
No.
¿Quién me preguntó?
Ahí, yo, Andrea.
Andrea, ok, todavía no me los ubico por la voz. All right, but Andrea, left. Es un noun que significa izquierdo o izquierda, pero también is a verb, específicamente a simple past verb, de la manera de live. ¿Ok? ¿Ok, Andrea?
Ok.
Ajá. So, for example, if you say leche, how do you say leche in English?
Milk.
And how do you say ordeñar una vaca in English? Se dice igual, milk.
Milk.
Yes. You know, my father milks the cow in the farm. Okay? My father or my uncle milks cows because he sells milk. Okay, so So milk can be el verbo ordeñar, and milk can be leche too. Is clear? Yep.
Yes.
Okay, very good, very good. Está bien la pregunta, está bien, Carol, esa pregunta. Very good.
Teacher,
yes, Pablo.
Sí, es decir que esas, todas esas son las preguntas, las palabras compuestas.
¿Cuáles, Pablo?
Bueno, milk cow es hacer de, es como ya conjugar las dos palabras. Entonces, si decimos milk cow, es ordeñar la vaca.
Ah, ok, ahorita le digo. Very good. I milk the cow. Mm-hmm. Aquí tenemos, we have, espérenme cuando, si me ven que me tardo un ratito es porque aquí hay, está una barrita de herramientas y hay que buscar qué usar. Okay, so here we have the verb, ahí tenemos el verbo y aquí tenemos a quién. All right, for example, ¿o a qué? For example, the subject, el sujeto es I, the verb is milk, and the object o el complemento le vamos a poner, porque si le pongo object, it's like, okay, is the cow. Podemos ponerle aquí también in the morning, right? I milk the cow in the morning. Okay, I milk the cow in, sorry, aquí es separado, se me, lo puse muy junto. So you say, I milk the cow in the morning. Okay, in the morning. Y aquí ya conjugamos la oración, Pablo. Okay?
Ah, okay.
Yeah, I milk, yes?
Pensé que era así como las... las que vimos la vez pasada de ice cream.
Las palabras compuestas, las, for example, ice cream. Ajá. Yes, hot dog. Yeah, de esas.
Ajá.
Ajá, no, de... aquí no, no. Milk es el verbo, porque también puede ser verbo. O sea, milk puede ser leche, right? Milk puede ser leche. Y leche, la palabra leche, si hablamos de gramática, es un sustantivo. En inglés, sustantivo se dice noun. Or milk can be ordeñar. Ordeñar, it can be a verb. Puede ser un verbo, a verb. ¿Ok? Otro ejemplo sería book. Book is libro. As a noun. But also book is reservar, a verb. Por ejemplo, cuando usted dice, voy a reservar una habitación en el hotel Bahía Dorada, right? You say, yo voy a, futuro, I will book a room. No dice, yo voy libro, no, book, reservar, ¿ok? Porque hay palabras en inglés que tienen más de un significado. Is it clear? In the hotel. Okay. Is it clear, everybody?
Kind of.
Okay. Vaya. Ahorita no se preocupen, que esto es con la práctica. Cuando vayamos avanzando, right? Vamos a ir viendo de estas cosas, palabras and everything. Lo que yo les voy a sugerir es que si ustedes quieren, for example, mejorar su vocabulario, incrementar el vocabulario, yo sé que no hay tiempo. I know that there is no time. No hay tiempo. Si yo les digo, lean algo, ay, mentira. ¿Ok? Y aparte, si no nos gusta mucho leer. Entonces, ¿qué le voy a recomendar? Vea más películas en inglés. All right, watch movies in English. Watch movies in English. Puede empezar como, ok, movie in English, subtitle in Spanish. Movie in English, subtitle in Spanish. Y puede empezar con una película que usted ya haya visto muchas veces y ya la conozca, hasta los diálogos. ¿Ok? Por ejemplo, alguien me dijo, no sé si fue en este grupo, Si alguien me dijo la película favorita era Forrest Gump. No. No, no fue en este grupo. Pero lo que puede hacer es, ok. Ah, voy a ver la película. ¿Qué película ha visto usted muchas veces, José Roberto?
The Noun. Noun.
Sorry?
The Noun. Creo que así se dice, monja.
Uy, la de miedo.
Sí, en la agencia con Pablo la poníamos bastante.
Uy, Pablo, por eso que asustan ahí. All right, no. Ok, now, for example, imagínese usted, ya ha visto esa película muchas veces, ahora lo que puede hacer es ponerla en English.
Ok.
Watch the movie in English. No, not in Spanish, I mean, in English. So you can, you watch the movie in English, you read the captions in English, y así uno va aprendiendo vocabulary. Así es como vamos a ir aprendiendo vocabulary. Nos tenemos que meter en el idioma, in the language. All right, very good. Ok, Andrea, are you happy with the answer?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, all right, very good, excellent. Now, the next one, everybody, is it. Wait, which is the option? It is, it was, or it were? Which is the option, everybody? A, B, or C?
B.
B, okay, very good. It was. Fue un buen regalo. It was a good present. What about the next one? A, B, or C?
B.
Which is the correct option? B, very good. B, excellent. Did she arrive? Okay. Did she arrive? No con el verbo en pasado, in present. Let's see. Si las de arriba no salen malas es porque las puse todas en mayúscula. ¿Y por qué me lo...? No, come on. Ok, very good. Aquí no las ha de haber puesto malas porque no las pusimos en mayúscula. Let's see. Yeah, because it's Mrs. Harris took the train. Sí, la quería quizás en mayúscula la respuesta. Okay, but don't worry. Nos sacamos 10. We got a 10. All right, very good. Okay, very good, everybody. Now, are you ready for the quiz?
Oh.
No. Okay, very good. Vaya, vamos a hacer un repaso. We're going to make a little review. Okay, we're gonna make a little review. All right, let's see. Voy a borrar acá. I'm gonna erase here. We're gonna make a little review. What's the simple past of go?
Went.
Went. What's the simple past of drink?
Drunk.
Okay.
Drunk.
Okay, very good. What's the simple past of, give me a second because esta letra está muy grande. Okay. What's the simple past of get?
Got.
Okay, give me a second.
Got.
Okay, very good. So you say go, went, drink, drank, get, got. What about, le voy a enseñar uno nuevo, rise. Rise es elevar, right? Rise. So the simple past is rose, como rosa, rose. Okay, rise, rose. What about buy?
But.
Bought, okay, very good. Y lo ponemos así, buy, bought. Teach?
Teacher.
Ajá, what is the simple past of teach? The simple past of teach is taught. Okay, very good. El quiz que les traigo no es de escribir nada, sino que solo es de unir, okay? Así que por eso, para que primero se familiaricen viéndolos, pero sí hay que aprenderlos, okay, teach, taught. What about bring? What is the simple past of bring?
Brought.
Brought, very good. The simple past, traer, of bring is brought. What is the simple past of choose? Seleccionar, choose.
Yes.
Chose, very good, like this, chose, chose. What is the simple past of be, verb to be?
Was.
Was and?
Were.
Were, very good. What's the simple past of drink? Ay, we ya lo tenemos. Read. What is the simple past of read?
Read.
Read, okay, very good. Es el mismo, pero la pronunciación diferente. Read, read. Okay, what about cut?
Cut.
Cut, all right, very good. Cut, cut. What about swim?
Swam.
Swam, very good. We changed the letter. What about do?
Das.
Das is present, remember. El das es presente.
Did.
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 What about write?
Wrote.
Wrote, okay, wrote. Very good. Very good. El examen de ahora no va a ser de escribir verbos. Va a ser solo de matching. Pero ya la otra semana les voy a dar uno de escribirlos. Así que hay que estudiarlos. All right, let me see. What about understand?
Understand.
Este es nuevo. Understand. What is the past?
Understand.
No.
No.
La mayoría que les estoy dando ahorita son irregular. Okay, this one is like this. Understood. Understood. Yeah, understood. Very good. Understand, understood. Solo es para que lo vea. Let's see. Forget.
Forgot.
Forgot. Very good. Forget, forgot. What about, let's see. Fly.
Flew.
Flew, all right, fly, flew, very good, fly, flew. What about take? We have take, take, okay, take.
Talk.
Took, very good. What about have? Have, what is the past?
Have,
okay, very good, have. What about, let me see. What about drive?
No. Drove.
Drove, all right. Si usted se fija, algunos verbos solo les cambiamos la letrita. Como les digo, no van a escribir verbos ahora, solo es de relacionarlos, all right? To relate verbs, to make a matching. Okay, the next one. What's the meaning of send? What is the past of send?
Send.
Sent.
Sent.
We only change the last D for T. Sent. What about, we have go. Okay, very good. Let's see. Go, go, go. Build, for example, construir, build. What is the past? No lo conocemos, ¿verdad? Sorry, builder. Pablo.
Builder.
Ok, este es irregular. Entonces vamos a hacer esto, build. Very good, build. Ok, let's see. What about... take, we have take, forget, get, write. See. What is the past of see?
So.
So.
So, very good. See, so. See, so. All right, very good. What about, let me see. Otro que se nos escape, let's see. In present. Can you tell me, everybody? Otro verbo que se nos escape.
Make.
Make. Very good. Make. What is the past of make?
Made.
Made. All right. Very good. Made. Okay. What about?
Run.
Run.
Run, ran.
Very good. Run, ran. Le cambiamos una letra. Okay. What about break? It. Quebrar. Break.
Broke.
Broke.
Broke. Very good. Broke. Break. Broke. Okay. What about fall? Caer.
Fall.
Fail. Okay, very good. Caer, fall, fail. What about, let me see, for you. Fight, pelear, fight. Fault, no. All right, very good. Fault, five, fault. What about leave, irse, leave, left. Yeah. Okay. Ok, very good. So, hay algunos que no cambian mucho. Los que cambian mucho son estos. Pay attention. Buy, bought. Bring, brought. Let me see what else. Otro que cambia mucho. Tal vez este, fly, flew. Fight, fought. All right, very good. They can change a little bit. Pueden cambiar un poco. They can change a little bit. But not that much. Okay. So, ahorita, right now, I'm gonna send you, les voy a mandar, I'm gonna send you the link for the verbs. Give me a second. Okay, very good. I'm gonna give you the link for the verbs, for the quiz of verbs, que no está difícil. It is not. Yes?
Podría tomar la take a picture a la verb.
Ah, yeah, of course. Give me a second. Give me a second. Ahorita. Yes, go ahead.
Thank you.
Okay?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Nice. Okay. So right now, I'm going to give you the... I'm gonna give you the little quiz. It's not difficult. Okay, very good. Give me a second. Okay, very good. Aquí está. Okay, algunos solo los va a relacionar, right? Don't worry. Esto es como de diagnóstico. Quiero ver cómo andan. Let's see how you are. Okay, le voy a mandar el link al chat. Aquí from Zoom chat. Tal vez alguien nos hace el favor de pasarlo al WhatsApp, porque no tengo abierto WhatsApp web. Okay, maybe one person can send it. Okay, so right now you can take it. Lo hacemos, all right? Do it. Y después me manda el score al grupo. Quiero ver cómo sale. Okay, very good. Maybe one person can send the link to the group. Thank you very much, Nelson. Thank you very much. Ya lo mandó Nelson al grupo también. En Juan José. Okay, thank you very much. So right now, vaya, hágalo tranquilo, despacio, right? Because this is like just a diagnostic test. Okay? Very good. When you finish, you tell me. This is very easy, everybody.
Finished,
Maria Isabel. All right. Send me, please, the score. Ah, okay.
Finish.
Juan Jose Gonzalez, Ana Melara. Okay. Ah, very good. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. Okay. Vaya, déjenme apuntar ahorita. I'm gonna write it here. Okay. Very good.
Teacher.
Yeah.
Tengo un problema, fíjense que cuando quiero pasar el verbo a que yo considero que es correcto, no queda ahí pegado.
¿Y usted está en celular o en
Sí.
Ay, ay, ay. Isabel, you are from cell phone.
No.
From computer.
Yes, from computer.
Okay, give me a
mismo problema tengo también.
Quiero ver, give me a second.
Con los del lado derecho es.
Si quieren, háganlo un poquito más grande porque yo lo estoy haciendo del celular y sí puedo. Extiendan un poquito la pantalla.
Yo ya lo terminé, igual pude hacerlo.
Porque sí se puede, ¿ve? Ya van a ver, ¿ve? Sí se puede. Solo que tal vez hagan un poquito más grande la con los deditos la... screen. All right. Let me see Luis Fernando, Ana Melara. Okay, Ana Melara, Luis Rivera. Raquel mandó todas las respuestas, bórrelo. Borre la foto para todos, please. Solo necesito la del score. Uh-huh. Solo donde aparecen los numeritos en rojo, la nota. Thank you very much. Luis Fernando. Isabel, did you send me the score?
No, teachers, because I don't have a cell phone.
Last week I you are only from the computer.
Yes.
And how much did you get?
9.
9, okay.
9.
Okay, no, don't worry. Okay, I'm gonna write it here. Let's see, Sara. Okay, andamos bastante bien, yeah.
Finish, teacher.
Okay, yes, yes, I'm checking the scores. Connie, got it. Okay, very good. Vaya, en relacionarlos andamos bastante bien. Nazareth, all right, yes. Raquel, thank you, Raquel. Okay, Andrea. Yeah, we are fine. I mean, good grades. Jose Roberto, Carol. Wow, very good. I'm very happy. Carol Membreño. Okay. Very good. I'm very, very, very happy. So let me see. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11. I have 11. Jose, Ana, Melara, Luis, Isabel, Sara, Connie, Nazareth, Raquel, Andrea, Jose, Roberto, and Carol. Okay, I got 11. Okay, everybody. Well, ¿quiénes me hacen falta? Ah, Pablo, tranquilo, Pablo. Tómese el tiempo, okay? Don't worry. Pablo is missing. Let me see who else. Rosa Irma is missing. Don't worry. Take your time. Okay. Para los que ya terminaron, for the ones who finished. Okay. I'm gonna refresh your memory with tomorrow's presentation. Remember that tomorrow we have a presentation. Mañana vamos a estudiar ya el... Andrea. Ah, okay, very good. Okay, so everybody, we are going to have the presentation for tomorrow. Remember, the presentation, si usted quiere, if you want, you can prepare a PowerPoint presentation with pictures. Okay, for example, if you say, when I was a child, my favorite food was pizza, and you show a slice of pizza, right? Very good, or whatever. Ya se fijaron que pueden compartir, right? Very good. Thank you, Isabel. All right, you paid attention that you can share, right? You can share images. So you can begin your presentation with good morning, everybody, all right? Everybody, or you can say good morning, classmates, good morning, class, whatever you want, okay? And you can say, I will talk about my childhood, all right? Very good. Childhood es niñez. Okay, I will talk about my childhood. And you begin. I was born in San Salvador. I was born in 1984. When I was a child, and you say, characteristics from your personality. Okay, very good. For example, Juan Jose, what were you like when you were a child?
When I was a child, I was like to San Salvador.
Ah, okay. Wait. Remember, acuérdense qué significaba esta pregunta. What were you like? No sé si se acuerdan. What were you like when you were a child? Do you remember? ¿Se acuerdan de esa pregunta, everybody? ¿Qué significaba? What was the meaning of this question? Obviamente usted no me va a decir la pregunta. Usted solo me va a decir la respuesta. ¿Ok? ¿Se acuerdan? Do you remember the meaning of this question?
¿Qué nos gustaba de chiquito?
No.
El lugar.
No. ¿Quién se acuerda? Vamos a ver. Ya se les olvidó un poquito.
¿Qué te gustaba cuando eras pequeño?
No. ¿Quién tiene la imagen? Era? Sorry.
¿Cómo éramos de pequeño?
Exactly, very good. Eso significa. ¿Se acuerdan que les dije que en esa pregunta el verbo like, o sea, la palabra like no es verbo? Porque el verbo es este. I will show you. The verb is this. What were? Ok, pero aquí le están preguntando que cómo era usted. Es una pregunta que así es. I mean, hay que aprendérsela así de memoria, porque si la tratamos de traducir, no le vamos a encontrar meaning, all right? Very good. So, for example, si yo quiero, si usted me dice, ah, yo le quiero preguntar en presente a la teacher cómo es la mamá de ella. Si usted me dice, teacher, how is your mother? ¿Qué cree que le voy a contestar? Yo le voy a contestar, fine. Porque usted me está preguntando cómo está. How is my mom? Y yo le puedo decir, oh, she's fine, thank you. Ah, no, teacher, yo no le quise preguntar eso. Le quise preguntar que cómo es su mamá. Ah, entonces es, what is your mother like? Esa pregunta hay que aprenderla así de memoria, porque eso significa cómo era su mamá, cómo es su mamá. What is your mother like? Y ahí yo empiezo a decir, oh, my mother is, she's very lovely, she's very friendly, she's very kind, generous, kind-hearted, she's very, okay? Vale, entonces en pasado, cuando usted le quiere preguntar a alguien más, hey, ¿cómo eras tú de pequeño? The question is, what were you like when you were a child? Aunque veamos ahí la palabra like, porque como veíamos con la pregunta que nos hizo Andrea, algunas palabras en inglés no solo significan una cosa. ¿Ok? ¿Is it clear?
Yes, okay.
Entonces, usted en su usted en su presentación va a decir así. Ok, all right, everybody, when I was a child, no le voy a hacer la pregunta, right? But when I was a child, I was terrible. I was terrible. I was angry. I was happy. And I was selfish, okay, etcétera, etcétera, etcétera. Pero ya si yo le pregunto a usted, okay, what were you like when you were a child? Le estoy preguntando cómo era de personalidad, okay? Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah, very good. Okay, so I will repeat my question. Juan José, what were you like when you were a child?
When I was a child, I was terrible. I was happy, friendly.
Oh, really? This is a question. Were you troublemaker? Troublemaker es que si se metía en problemas, si era tremendo. I mean, like, que traía los problemas a la casa. Were you troublemaker?
Kind of.
Yeah, me too. Yes. I was troublemaker, yes. I remember my neighbors came to my house and knocked my door and told my mom, Anita hit Arturito because I was terrible. Okay, very good. Let's see, Isabel, what were you like when you were a child?
When I was a child, I was shy.
And right now, Isabel, are you shy?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Yeah, you are shy and a little timid.
Yes, and angry too.
But right now or when you were a child?
Always.
Yeah, me too, but sometimes in my class I have to be happy. Yes, okay.
Yes, I see.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Isabel. All right, let's see. Andrea, what were you like when you were a child?
When I was a child, I was terrible.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, but you didn't. Did you? Una pregunta. Did you hit children? Sorry. Pablo, me lo mandó con respuestas. Solo recorte donde aparece la nota, please. Borre la imagen para todos, please, please. Solo recorte donde está la respuesta. Thank you. All right. Okay. Andrea, did you hit other children when you were a child?
Yes, I did.
Terrible, terrible. Okay. Well, everybody, voy a pasar la lista rapidito porque ya no se nos terminó el tiempo. Okay, very good. Let's see. Connie Andres.
Here, teacher.
Okay. Very good. Let's see. Nazareth Aide.
Present.
Isabel Mejía.
I'm here.
Okay, very good. Let's see. Danilo Morales.
Here.
Okay. Erwin Rivera. Erwin. Aquí estaba, pero no sé qué le pasó, pero lo voy a poner presente. Raquel Sierra.
Presente.
Okay, presente. Okay. Don't worry. Okay. Well, everybody, mañana los espero con sus presentations, right? My favorite food when I was a child was, my favorite place when I was a child was, okay? No les voy a dejar nada de tarea ahora, solo para que se preparen. You can prepare yourselves. Thank you very much, everybody. I will see you tomorrow. Have a nice day. Have a nice morning. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Bon appetit in your breakfast. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.